And this should be good. We've got the defending Olympic champion in the first heat, drawn in lane four. That's three in from the right hand. They're not using lane one. There are the records. Donkova back in 1988, 12:21. Joan Hayes, 12:37. That's a very good Olympic record. It could be under threat this time. Well, there's the start list then. Lane two, Holder of Canada. Three, Williams, Jamaica. Four, Harper, USA. Five, Talley, Belarus. Six, Schott of Austria. Seven, Akori of France. Eight, Nitra, Germany. And nine, Galeskaya of Russia. Just the first two, so these are tough semi-final heats, these, plus the two fastest to the final. So really, it is a very, very competitive all-out situation, as one would expect in the semi-final. There are three heats in this semi-final round. Right on the inside, Nikita Holder of Canada, sixth in the World Championship final last year, incidentally. 12.8, her best set this year. Next to her is Charlene Williams of Jamaica, with 13.07 in the heat. She has a 12.78 to her credit, though, this season. The defending Olympic champion, Dawn Harper, 12.75 in her heat. 12.47, her best last season. Talley of Belarus won her heat in 12.71. Medals at the World Indoor and European Championships already this year, so doing very nicely. And that's Schlott of Austria, the Austrian record holder, fourth in the European Championships this year, just out of the medals. Akori, the Frenchwoman, the European Junior Champion back in 1999, Olympic semi-finalist last time, and also a semi-finalist in the World Championships held in Berlin in 2009. Kellie Nitra, European Indoor Champion last season, reached the semi-final of the Olympics last time, and also the World Championships. Galitskaya of Russia, Russian Indoor Champion, went to the World Indoor Championships, made the semi-final, 12.78 at best. As I say, the first two to go through. This is a pretty even race, actually, looking down the times coming into the race. Holder, Williams, Harper, Talley, Schlott, Okori, Nitra, Galitskaya. Heat one of the semi-final round.
On your mark.
100 meter hurdles. First two and the two fastest through to the final. I think her championship is over. It's a false start and a blatant one too, unless there was any other reason. Look at this, three from the left, that was blatant. Well, Corey, the former European champion, 12.72 this season, but I think that could be the end of her championship. I don't think there won't be a green card this time, I don't think. It was absolutely blatant. She can't believe what she's done. Well, let's get the confirmation first of all. The card is out and it is delivered. So, Akori is gone. That's a shame. So, Holder, Williams, Harper, Talley, Schrott, Nitra, Galitskaya, the athletes left, as Akori leads, the Frenchwoman. How disappointing for her. First two and two fastest to the final. Dawn Harper drawn in lane four. That's three in from the right as you watch. They're not using lane one. It's often confusing with the lanes, but
fair.
It's a pretty even start, certainly. Harper going very strongly, so is Williams on the far side, looking very strong. And it looks as though Kellie coming through, but it's and that's a photograph for second. That's a photograph for second. 12.46, easily through the Olympic champion from 2008. But the rest coming through the line, that really was very, very tight indeed.
And PB for Harper, 12.46, and then we had, as you said, Williams, Kellie and Schrott almost in a line.
Yeah. Well, Schrott has been given the second place. When we look at the slow motion, we will see how close that was. Williams, they're both given the same time, Schrott and Williams, and that's interesting, isn't it? Schrott, well, Harper, forget Harper, she's won this quite comfortably. Williams was going very strongly in the early stages and still a contender in the end. Let's have a look at this. Schrott, tall blonde figure in the middle. Oh gosh, you still can't read that. You've got to rely on the photograph and on the computers, because there's no way that you can tell from that photograph. You have to see the slow motion, or rather the photograph, to check that out. But that's a very good performance by the defending champion. It really is. Let's have another look. You can't actually see.
You need to look
you
at the
can't
photo.
See there,
there it is.
Ah, there it is.
And now
ah,
you
yes,
can see
yes,
the
yes.
lines just a little bit. But I mean. So very, very close.
That is a close second place.
Well, it's crucial, of course, because only two go through, so Schrott is through, and Williams have to see whether her time is quick enough, and perhaps even Kellie as well.
There it is, Harper, Schrott, Williams. But Williams will have to wait. Look at that, the same time. Look, those three, 1/100th of a second between them.
But, of course, we saw Harper having her foot strap. Well, there didn't seem to be any problem, because she's just gonna improved her personal best by 1/100th, and that's the personal best that she did in the World Championships last year.
And in the jump, long jump, we have Karin May Melis for Turkey. She previously competed, or she was a South African who then changed allegiances. And that looks a pretty good jump. She gets the white flag. And you can see that flag fluttering around a little bit over there. She's nicely onto the board. Good speed on the runway. Good lift, and 6.80 meters, so she's a second automatic qualifier. And this is Deloach of the US of A. This is good sprinting. Oh wow, no leg shoot, goes over the automatic qualifying, thank you very much. Spikes off, and she'll be going back to the village pretty quickly. That looks so easy, that was ridiculous. So fantastically on the board, good speed, gets up off the board without having to really work too hard with the leg sheet. And that's gone over the automatic qualifying of 6.70 and 6.81. For a competition, this is all about getting qualifying out of the way.
That was into a headwind of minus 1.8 metres per second as well.
It looked ridiculously easy, didn't it? Fantastic jumping from Deloach from the USA.
Well, just getting ready for the second heat, and here is Sally Pearson, major candidate for Athlete of the Year awards last year of her brilliant sprint hurdling, both in the semi-final and final of the World Championships in Daegu. So we've got two finalists from 2008 coming back here. Pearson was the silver medalist last time, and Lolo Jones was leading until she crashed into the ninth hurdle and ended up in seventh place, so she's hoping to atone for that. An athlete who's won two world indoor titles. That's Lolo Jones, who we'll see very shortly. She goes in lane four in this race. Well, let's meet the full field from the inside. Here is Yulia Kondakova of Russia, world indoor finalist 4 years ago, got a best of 12.79. Next to her, an athlete who always seems to excel when it comes to major championships. That's Dervil O'Rourke, because she hasn't had much form this year, but she goes and runs a season's best of 12.91 when it comes to the heat. She peaks very well. And here's Lolo Jones, well, a personal best of 12.43, just outside the world all-time top 10. And she, of course, did 12.43 in Beijing in her semi-final, only to crash in the final. Aline Berings, Belgium, former European indoor champion at 60-meter hurdles. Junior champion on his full flight of 100 meter hurdles. Here's Jessica Zelenka. We saw her, of course, in the heptathlon, but she beat a very good field to win the Canadian title at this event. 12.65 she ran on that occasion in Calgary. Here is the favourite, a favourite for the title. Sally Pearson looked magnificent in her heat when she ran 12.57. Last year, of course, she ran a brilliant 12.28, the fourth fastest ever. Tiffany Porter of Great Britain. Injuries question mark, but she was, of course, good in the indoor season when she took the world indoor silver medal. And finally, the Bahamas record holder, Evanique Kemp, holds that record at 13.13. So the two finalists 4 years ago in this lineup are Lolo Jones in lane four and Sally Pearson in lane seven. And Zelenka and Porter, either side of Pearson, have shown the sort of pedigree and the sort of form that make them candidates on for the final as well. Sally Pearson taking to her marks in lane seven in the second of the races in the semi-final round of the women's 100-meter hurdles. Side from the Russian as well, but this is all about Sally Pearson going well away from the rest of the field. A brilliant run once again by Pearson. She takes that. Zelenka of Canada came up for second place, but once again, just as she showed in Daegu, she ran a brilliant time there. It's the fastest time in the world this year. It's 12.39 for Sally Pearson, and she looks a cast iron favourite. And once again, a brilliant demonstration of sprint hurdling, Stuart.
Yes, she does. She hurdles so well, and she's so quick. She's an 11-second flat sprinter. Lola Jones was third in my book. I thought she came through third. Zelenka's definitely got second, clearly second. But look at the way she gets to the first hurdle. Her trail leg is so quick, it brings the lead leg down so fast. But her basic speed exceeds anyone else in this race. And that's the thing that is a great advantage. But she comes off the hurdle so quickly with real momentum. And it really is a very, very fine piece of hurdling. First hurdle, establish the rhythm of the race. Get off it quick. In other words, pull the trail leg through. That means the action and reaction, the front leg will come down quickly. And she just, look at her shoulders. They stay on the same level the whole way. It's a wonderful piece of hurdling. And that is a classy time, isn't it? 12.39.
Wow. And as you said, Lolo Jones was third place. And I think 12.71 should be enough to advance. He was just ahead of Porter, 12.79. Those are both quicker than the third place in the first semi.
Yeah, it was only 200 outside the Olympic record, that.
And now we go to the high jump. The bar has been moved up to 225. And this is Yukov from Russia. And a good clearance from Uhoff. See here, just builds up nicely into the take-up area. Take-off zone. Reaches up over high point, nicely over the bar, and he just follows with his legs. There's some interesting taping going on these bodies that we've just seen here taking their vest off. So this is Williams, first attempt at 2 meters 25. He cleared 221 his first attempt. Very tidy, very compact high jumper is Jesse Williams.
Interestingly, he was only fourth in the US trials, and of course they automatically take first three, except that the man ahead of him hadn't qualified.
Wow, that's an interesting fact, but he's also the 2011 world champion.
Right, he's a major contender.
Yeah, so he must have had a bit of a mare in the championships, but he's here and he's going clear. He's got two clears at 2.25.
Oh, well, once again, looking at Sally Pearson, so beautifully balanced all the way through this hurdles race. And she wins that second semi-final in 12.39. Zelenka 12.66. And Lolo Jones may well be in the final with her 12.71. The wind was just a little bit behind that race at 1.3 meters per second.
And making his entry into the high jump competition we have Robbie Grabas from Great Britain. He missed out on 220. He decided he's going to at 225 this high. And he goes clear. And the roar from the crowd, they like that. So good speed on the runway. Runs a lovely arc as he comes into the takeoff area. And then just uses that speed to take him up. He looks pretty confident to me. So he goes clear at 225. And he's now in joint first position of many.
Well, we've got the men's 800 metre semi-finals coming up this afternoon. And of course, David Rudisha, well, that's Khaki, in fact, before we go to, I'm sure they'll show Rudisha. Khaki, who's had in different form during the season, but he is certainly a threat to everyone in very good form. He really is. There's Amos. He won his heat and looked very good indeed coming into the next round, the semi-final round. Borzakovsky, he's very difficult to assess. Borzakovsky, you never know what he's going to do, whether he runs it from the front, whether he gets involved, or whether he doesn't. Aman, another of the Ethiopian competitors who will surely make his presence felt in the semi-finals. And there's David Rudisha. He is by far the best 800 meter runner, is the world record holder. He's run several 800s in sub 142 this season, so. And he can do it with or without a pacemaker, I can tell you. He's so elegant. So the third semi-final, or the third heat of the semi-final round of the women's 100 hurdles, Zagle of Belgium, Rolder of Germany, Dektyareva of Russia, Wells of the United States, Yanit of Turkey, George of Canada, Caravelli of Italy, and Skrobakova of the Czech Republic in lane 9. There are the two fastest losers so far, Jones and Porter of Great Britain. Early days though yet. Zagre, the Belgian record holder, was fifth in the European Championships just recently in Barcelona. 13.04 in qualifying. She came through as a fastest qualifier to this round. You see that small queue just being introduced to the crowd. Well, this is Cindy Rolder, the European under 23 bronze medalist last year, semi-finalist in the World Championship. She was seventh in the European Championships just recently in the final. Dekatereva of Russia, 12.81, her best, and Russian champion. Didn't get through the heats of this event last time, 4 years ago. Kellie Wells is the only one in the world that's beaten Sally Pearson of Australia. She did that last time out. But she too is somewhat erratic. You can't really say she should qualify here. But Yanit also, the Turkish twice European champion, World Student Games champion 2 seasons ago, Turkish record 12.61. She looked good in qualifying as well. And there's Felicia George of Canada, 12.72, her best. World finalist last year in Daegu, 12.83 in qualification. She qualified by right. Well, this is Caravelli of Italy, broke the Italian 100-meter hurdles record, which has stood to Tuzzi since 1994. Just broke this and broke that last year in May. And Shrobakova of the Czech Republic holds their record indoor and out. Didn't get through the semi-final of the European Championships though, just recently. Reached the semi-final of the last two World Championships though. So this is the third heat of the semi-final round of the women's hurdles. Zagre, Rolda, Dekrajeva, Wals, Yanit, George, Caravelli, and Skrobakova. Kellie Wells had a terrific start, so did Yanit, and these two ahead of George, they're coming through very strongly. And this is Kellie Wells at her best, really, with Yannett in second place at the moment. Wells wins it, Yannett comes into second place, in third place George, then Degrieva. And the time, 12.52, that went with the form book. But Kellie Wells was second in the US Olympic trials, incidentally. It was in London where she beat Sally Pearson. That was a big upset, and Sally was very upset about that. But Kellie Wells gets that, she's through to the final later on. And that was a very good run indeed. Can't really tell how good they're going to be in the final, but you know, when you get that sort of start, the only disadvantage she has over Pearson is that Pearson is quicker on the flat, and she can make room for those hurdles with her, you know, reaction time is very, very good. Quite impressed by Yannett as well, the Turkish athlete.
And indeed, she's got a national record out of it, 12.58, and George has done a personal best, 12.65. She'll go through to the final, so too will Lola Jones. Because Dektayeva here ran 12.75 in fourth.
Yeah, really attack the hurdle, lean into it, run off it, just get down to that track as quick as possible and really get stuck into the sprinting. That's what it's all about. But Kellie Wells, I expected her to get through, and so she did.
And here we go with Hannanay for his third attempt at 2 meters 25. So Hannanay of France will go out at the second height in this final. We started at 2 meters 20. He went clear the second attempt on that. And now he has failed three times at 2.25.
Sorry, coach, is the message.
Yeah, I did my best, coach. So here we'll walk back and you can see that three crosses against Mikhail Hannanay's high jump scorecard. So there was an earlier failure from the Cypriot, Ayanu, who also has gone out at 2.25. So the competition now is down to its true final number of 12.
Another look at Kellie, look at the way in which she runs off the hurdle too. Just not quite got the momentum off the hurdle that Sally Pearson demonstrated, but she's still very much in contention for a medal, that's for sure.